So how do you use the Active Trader tab in Thinkorswim? In this video, you're going to learn everything you need to know so you can effectively use this feature. Hey, how's it going? On this channel, you will learn the steps it takes to make a full-time income trading in the stock market. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. And today, we're talking about the Active Trader tab in Thinkorswim. So if you don't know where the Active Trader tab is, it's in the charts. So if you're just in charts, it's gonna be on these tabs on the side. So all the way on the right here, and you will see Active Trader, and clicking that will bring up the Active Trader window. Now, the first few basic things it has in here is you can buy and sell right at the market. So you don't even have to worry about a price. You can just say that I wanna buy in right away. If we click on this, it'll just instantly fill us at this price. And then we can say sell at market, or we can reverse if we wanted just to instantly short that position that we just made long. And then if we wanted to close that position without selling at, you know, if we had a bunch of different weird positions open and you just wanted to flatten, that's what this button is. It just closes all your trades. And so if we click flatten, that just closes everything that we have. So you don't have to think about, oh, if I'm short, I need to buy, or if I'm long this many, I need to sell this many. It just closes them all out for you without you having to think. So that's really nice. A few things you'll notice, this little drop down arrow, you can change the quantity of either shares or, for in this case, futures contracts you're trading. So, you know, they have a few quick ones here, but you can also just type in, you know, a number in here that you want. So if you were trying to buy a certain amount of shares, or just trade a certain amount of size of whatever kind of asset you're trading, this is how you want to do that. And then over here, you have auto send. And all that does is make it so you can either quickly sell something and buy something without having to say confirm. So if I have this auto send unclicked and I click buy market, it's going to bring up a confirmation dialogue. And then I'm going to have to click send to do that. Now, if I just have this auto send on, I can just click sell market right away, and it will do that instantly without me having to confirm. So that's the idea of this Active Trader. It's a lot more designed for you to make trades really quickly without having to go through the more steps in there that they have. Now here you will see that it has how many positions you have open, and then your average price that you got in. So if you're buying shares at different prices, it'll kind of say your average price of getting all those shares combined. And then it'll also tell you your profit loss for the overall trade and then the day. And you can change that by clicking here and say customize. And then that allows you to, you know, add different things. So you can take these away if you don't want to see those. And then you can also add things as well. So if we actually wanted to see those, we could add those. Now there's a few other different settings you can mess with. There's this little tiny gear here, and that actually edits this more Active Trader tab window here where you can see the prices moving. So this is where you can change that you want to see either the volume here, so that's this, and then the buy orders. And so you can add different things. So you can actually say one that's kind of cool is you can add PL open. And then so what that'll do is if I buy one share here, or one contract, it'll say, okay, if the contract goes all the way up here, I'm up this much money, or if it goes down here, I'm down this much money. Now to give a quick explanation on what this shows, just on the right here, this volume, that shows you how much trading volume has happened at each one of those prices. So at this exact price right here, about 9,000 contracts have been traded, or if it was a stock, 9,000 shares would have been traded. And then, you know, in the center, it's the actual price. And then another way to set limit orders in here, instead of using this buy market or sell market, you can actually say that you want to do either a buy stop. So it'll default if the price is below, it'll do a buy stop. So I can click on this, and if the price got up to this point, it would send in a market order and I would instantly get filled. Now, another one, if it's below that, it would be a limit order. And so I can have this set up to do a limit order down here. Now you can see that for the stops, it says hold control to use a limit order. And so I can change this to a limit order if I don't want that to be a stop order. Now on the other side, it'll be a sell limit for shorting and then a sell stop down here. So I can tell it to, if it gets to this price down here, I want to short the stock. And currently what that would actually do right now is, because you can see up here, I have one position long right now. It would close my position out. And you can see over here, this price is changing, that I am currently down about $40. So another way to just close these is I can click on the actual chart, the little X, or over here, you can click the X. Now, to move these around really quickly, you can easily do that by clicking and dragging in here, and that'll quickly move those up. So it's a really nice and smooth interactive setup for making these quick trades. Now, one thing that's really cool about the active trader is that they have templates. So right now I'm on buying or selling a single contract or share, right? And so if you click on this template, they have different things. OCO orders, which is other order cancels other, or essentially I can set this to buy either at this limit or buy at the stop. So what this order does, well, you can see the market just jumped up a ton. What this order did, let me just input it again so you can see this. So what this order does is, if it gets up to here, it'll buy it. And if it gets down to here, it'll buy it as well. So the idea is, if the market's exploding here like it is right now, we will instantly get filled without having to chase the stock. And it, or if it comes down here, we will be able to buy into the market at a more safer price. So we can either try to be buying at the lows instead of buying at the highs. So it's just kind of a different strategy. And then the other templates on here are brackets. And so this is a few different brackets. And so just this initial one is trigger with bracket. And so all this does is, it's essentially either a buy order or a sell order. And then it automatically puts in a stop loss and a profit taking target. So what we have here, up here, you can see that you have these two links that it's done at. And so right now it is 1 point off, or one, you know, a $1 move in this. So what we have is, you can see that here it's a limit order for the profit target. And then for the stop loss, it's going to be a stop order. So if we go in here and say buy one, and then hopefully get filled on that, it'll instantly fill that. And you can see that here we have this stop order to cut our losses, and then the limit order to take our profits. And again, you can move these around either on the chart or below, or on the active trader. And then you can also see this little gear on the side. That means these are linked. And so once one of these gets filled, the other order will get canceled. So you don't have to worry about the other order. Now, another thing you can do is you can actually move this order around by clicking on the little gear and dragging this. So that's a quick way to kind of change this if you wanted to move that around as some sort of kind of trailing stop loss. The other orders in here are trigger with two brackets or three brackets. Now, what this does is, it's essentially the same thing, but it's just, you have more versatility with more brackets. So you can see up here, it has three different brackets, and you wanna make sure, because this one is three, you can see down here, it doesn't show that I can buy. That is because I have three brackets, I need three contracts at a minimum. So now that you can see up here, each one of these has at least a one in it. So I will be able to buy, let's just close out of these real quick. And then I can buy this, and then it will set up three different brackets. So this would be, you know, more of if I wanted to have some sort of, you know, buy order, and then see, I can change these as easily as whenever I want. And, you know, I have some sort of scale out. So let's say I buy here and I want to sell some here, and then sell some up here, and then sell the last of it up here. So this is a way you can kind of easily scale out of a trade and not having to kind of watch the stock. This puts it in beforehand. You don't have to worry about watching the chart and doing this yourself. You can pre-put this in or to do that for you. Now, going back to this template, there's actually a really cool thing you can do is you can save these. So right here, you can see I have two that I've already saved. And so if I wanted to save this setup as, you know, having it have a stop loss all be at the same, and then having those different profit levels, I can set these to what I want. And then this little button right here allows me to save it. So I can just save this as three bracket setup. And then this will allow me to use this every time. So I can click on this and you can see that it's down here. A few other quick things I want to go over is this cancel button right here. This will cancel all these, you know, if I have these orders here, I can just click cancel all and that'll close all those orders for me. And then another thing is on the side over here, sometimes you will have it for a stock. It'll be zoomed in really far. So you will be seeing each one of these increments will be pennies, and that it can be way too much for a stock. So just one way to change that is you can zoom out here. And so you can see that changes the increments here, or I can zoom back in. And then also sometimes the active trader, as the stock moves up or down, it for some reason won't follow it. It'll usually try and keep this centered, but sometimes it'll, you know, move like this and then you won't see any of the activity. So this button right here will center it back for you so you can quickly do that without having to scroll and find where it's at. The last thing is just be aware that I was getting filled instantly on these trades because this is a simulated account. Now, in the real world, in an actual non-simulated account, you won't always get filled instantly. So especially with limit orders, you won't get filled right away. Sometimes it'll have to go through that price for you to get filled. And so just be aware when you're using the simulator versus the actual trader, is the simulator will get filled instantly. You can see right now the market is actually closed. That's why this isn't moving anymore. I can actually buy and get filled even though the market is closed. So that doesn't really make sense. The market's closed, but I can still buy and sell stuff. And so just be aware of that when you are trading. So I hope you found this video useful. If you want to learn more about the Thinkorswim platform, feel free to check out my playlist on Thinkorswim right here and see if any of those videos in there will help you. Now, if you want to just learn more about the stock market in general, feel free to subscribe to the channel. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask them in the comments below.